Palestinian civilians who have been killed by Israeli Defense Forces were later described as Hamas militants simply because they made the lethal mistake of simply existing in one of Israel's so-called kill zones. That's not me just saying this. This is based on reporting out of Israel by Haaretz. Now, according to Haaretz, Israel is now saying that 9,000 out of the 32,000 people killed in Gaza were allegedly Hamas militants. If you can remember, not too long ago, the military was alleging that 12,000 out of the 32,000 were Hamas militants. Now they're changing their tune. But even the 9,000 number is very likely incorrect, and I'll explain why in just a moment. Now, according to the reporting, the Israeli army says 9,000 terrorists have been killed since the Gaza war began. Defense officials and soldiers, however, tell Haaretz that these are often civilians whose only crime was to cross an invisible line drawn by the IDF. A host of reserve and standing army commanders who have talked to the publication cast doubt on the claim that all of these were terrorists. They imply that the definition of terrorist is open to a wide range of interpretation. It's quite possible that Palestinians who never held a gun in their lives were elevated to the rank of terrorist posthumously, at least by the IDF. In practice, a terrorist is anyone the IDF has killed in the areas in which its forces operate, according to one of the reserve officers who spoke to the publication. So basically, if you are a Palestinian who, by the way, none of them know where the kill zones are. So if you're a Palestinian who happens to wander into a so-called kill zone, the IDF takes you out immediately and labels you as a Hamas militant.
Okay, and I want to give more context here. So number one, based on what Anna's saying already, they said 12,000, now they're saying 9,000. What does that tell you? That tells you they were lying earlier. That's now establishes a fact. Because I've debated now several different people on air where they've used that 12,000 number. So I assume they're all going to go and retract right now on Twitter and all these other places. Oh, I'm sorry, it turns out the IDF were goddamn liars and I didn't mean to believe them. Now it's down to 9,000. And wait, should I believe that? Because the earlier one was definitely a lie. It's now proven to be a lie. Will they say that? No, they will not. One of them will ever correct anything. Because the whole point is to lie and to do propaganda. And by the way, they will then say, oh, you should correct a tweet from like, earlier in November, because the hospital was kind of, yeah, we destroyed it before and after. But in the middle, there was some Palestinian dude that walked by and knocked over one of the bricks. You need to correct it, and everyone in media needs to correct it, right? Well, are you going to correct this? No. Are you going to correct the fact that UNRWA never was with Hamas and that Israel provided zero evidence of that? And that's also proven now? No, no one will ever correct those things. The Israeli government lies almost every time. And that's because they're a government. That's what governments do to protect their own ass. Okay, now moving on to the figures. So remember, about 23,000 of the 32,000 killed are women and children. And even the IDF knows it's kind of weird when you include women and children, you get caught rather easily.
Right.
That's why they realized, oh damn it, the math doesn't add up. We were pretending 12,000 were terrorists, 23,000 minus 32,000, 23. Okay, we gotta change the number, just change it. Just change it to 9,000. And that'll be justifiable because those will be males.
Because all men are allegedly Hamas militants.
Yes, if you don't know that, that's actually technically what the IDF has done in the past, where they said, anyone who's a male inside Gaza counts as a terrorist, an adult male. Okay, so now we're beyond that. Every adult male is a terrorist. This is the most deeply racist, bigoted, genocidal, point of view you could have. But now anyone inside a kill zone, men, women, and children, they're all terrorists. We kill them all. They're literally inside a kill zone. We murder them all and then go, well, posthumously, after they're dead, we're gonna call them terrorists, so it's okay.
It's disgusting.
You see how we're trying to avoid civilian casualties?
Okay.
Go ahead, say it. Say it, Americans. Go ahead.
Let me give you more, because you literally have IDF soldiers who are speaking to Haaretz about this, including one senior officer in Southern Command. That individual told the publication the following. It's astonishing to hear the reports after every operation regarding how many terrorists were killed. You don't need to be a genius to realize that you don't have hundreds or dozens of armed men running through the streets of Khan Yunis or Jabalia fighting the IDF. Further, this individual says, it's not that we invent bodies, but no one can determine with certainty who is a terrorist and who was hit after entering the combat zone or the kill zones of an IDF force.
So the kill zones, you know, are true, let alone the Haaretz reporting, let alone the fact that it's Israeli military in leaks that confirming it, etc. Guys, remember the three Israeli hostages that they killed? I don't know if that was a kill zone or not. I mean, it feels like the entire Gaza Strip's a kill zone, but they shot them without asking any questions, even though they had a white flag, they had no shirts right on, and they were speaking Hebrew. So if you're in a kill zone, somebody should follow up. And Haaretz, great reporting here. We appreciate it. You see that inside Israel, there's dissent. They're not a monolith, and there's some great reporting. So Haaretz should follow up that great reporting by asking, so were the three Israeli hostages inside a kill zone? Mm-hmm. Is that why you killed them without asking any questions? And is it the policy of the Israeli government to murder anyone inside a kill zone without ever asking any questions?
Yeah, that's a great question.
And by the way, is that how you make great efforts to minimize civilian casualties?
Every civilian casualty is a tragedy, Cenk.
It's a tragedy, but luckily it's not that big a tragedy, because after we kill them, we just call them terrorists.
That appears to be the case. And look, honestly, this reporting is so important in helping us understand previous stories that we've shared with you all, including the story, I remember there was Channel 4 News with a group of Palestinian men in Gaza. One of the men wanted to go back to a home in order to get his wife and his mother and other relatives out of the home. And so he's holding a white flag. It was very clear that they were innocent civilians. And as they were standing there waving their white flag and with news media right there, the IDF shot and killed the guy. So that must have been a kill zone.
Remember the 6-year-old that was stuck in the car? They send the ambulance to go rescue her, and the IDF murders her and everyone inside the ambulance. I don't know if that was a kill zone or if all of Gaza is a kill zone for the IDF. But so one of our members asked, hey, you know, is so, how can they possibly, here, I'll read it real quick. Theater Goddess said, if that attack was designed to minimize civilian casualties, I'd hate to see what it looks like when they try to attack citizens. Referring to the Al-Shifa hospital attack, where the reporter said afterwards it looked like it was out of a horror movie, 300 dead, the whole entire hospital destroyed. And that's an excellent question. If they were trying to minimize civilian casualties, that should be asked of the Israelis. But the reality is, guys, they're not trying to minimize any casualties. And their one point of pride is they say, no, we're not trying to murder everyone in Gaza, because if we wanted to, we could kill all of them. So you see how we're only doing a genocide and not a Holocaust. So we're the angels, we're the good guys, and we're the moral ones, and they're the dirty terrorists. I mean, after we killed them.
The final thing that I want to add to this story is every media organization that has given in to the bullying of the Israeli government to basically label the Palestinian Health Ministry as the Hamas-run Palestinian Health Ministry in order to delegitimize the figures coming from them, even though historically, time after time, their figures have been proven to be true. I want you to keep this reporting in mind, because which side is lying about casualties here? Which side is lying, Cenk?
Yeah.
Which side has been proven to lie, and which side, historically speaking, has proven to be accurate in the reporting of the death toll numbers?
This reminds me of Obamacare. The Republicans thought they were going to damage the Affordable Care Act by calling it Obamacare and go, ha ha, I see that'll hurt you. But it actually wound up not only helping the Affordable Care Act, but eventually helping Obama's popularity.
Right.
This is similar, because Israel says, you see those accurate numbers coming out of the Palestinian Health Ministry? That is no good Hamas. But wait a minute, we've just seen, according to your words, the Hamas health ministry be right almost every single time, and the IDF be wrong almost every single time. So you just accidentally did a giant ad for Hamas. So you can keep doing that ad. Oh, you should never report civilian casualties out of Gaza because Hamas has been exactly right about everything and Israel's a but. Wait, hold on. Oh yeah. No, I don't care. All I care is it real or is it not real? Is it true or is it not true? I know a lot of people in America, they don't care what's true. They just care my side. My side is always right. The other side is evil and terrorist and deserves to be murdered, okay? But if you're not a lunatic and you haven't lost your mind because of bias, etc., all of us can see the health ministry has been right all along and the IDF has been proven to be gigantic liars at almost every step of the way.
One more quote. I can't help myself. It's really important to hear from people who actually know what's going on, including this following statement from a reserve officer. In every combat zone or kill zone, commanders define such kills, says the reserve officer. This means clear red lines that no one who is not from the IDF may cross so that our forces in the area are not hit. The boundaries of these kill zones are not determined in advance. As soon as people enter it, mainly adult males, orders are to shoot and kill, even if that person is unarmed, says the reserve officer.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. There's a very simple, much quicker way to get to that. There's a word for that. It's called terrorism. When you purposely kill unarmed civilians, you are a terrorist. And I don't care how much propaganda you do, if Israel is the one doing the terrorism, then their government officials and their IDF are the terrorists. And they have now killed 30 times the number of innocent civilians that Hamas has. We condemn Hamas. I don't think that's hard at all. That's their big trick. Oh yeah, you condemn Hamas. That did 1/30th of what Israel has done. Yes, easy, definitely condemn them. Now, do you condemn Israel that has killed 30 times as many women, children, babies, grandmothers, aunts, uncles, innocent civilians, murdered them and then said, well, they were inside a kill zone. So they had it coming, even if they're unarmed. Our order system is to murder everyone inside that zone. No, not terrorists, beloved angelic Israeli Defense Forces. No, sorry, not everyone inside there. It's not there, a lot of it's conscription. So for some portion of them, not their fault, like the American soldiers going to Vietnam, it wasn't their fault, it's the fault of the people giving the orders. But the people giving the orders inside the Israeli government are definitely terrorists and significantly worse terrorists than Hamas leaders. If that hurts your feelings, take it up with the Israeli government that has authorized even more murders of innocent civilians going forward, let alone what's already happened.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.